Yeah, here we go. I've got this painting. This is one of the second one I done in the first lot over at Manila. And I'm not happy. I'm not happy with it, even though I've got a bit of texture in there and stuff. I'm not happy. I don't mind the sky to a degree. I think I could come back through the sky just a little bit. But there's the fence needs to be finished across there. There needs some, there needs some darker areas in Aurora colours or dark Aurora colours in the front here. Could be a bit bare, I don't know. But I'll play around with it, and as I'm working around through it, I'll get that emotional response for the painting I'm going to do to work on it. Yeah. So, that's a bad sign, isn't it? But I've got this area here too. I'm going to find a little bit of red, a little bit of magenta, a little bit of cerulean blue, maybe a little bit of cad yellow, no, lemon yellow. Well, it doesn't matter, a little bit of everything there. Maybe even a little bit of warmth. Little red, cad maybe, and then I'm just gonna try and see how powerful that is. That could probably even sit a little bit better in there. Know what I mean? Make that a little bit dirt, put a little bit more warm yellow in that, and maybe even have a little bit of dark stuff in here. Now this area out in here seems to be okay. It seems to be a little bit abstractical in there, which I don't like. So, and you know what? This could take an hour, this could take another half hour, 40 minutes doing this before I get it to where I really, really feel happy. I need to put a little bit of that in there, a little bit of green, and get away from that real dark. I don't want that real dark colour. Needs a little bit of warmth in it. And maybe that's another thing too, isn't it? That warm and cool colours. Even though something's forward or back, you can still have your warms in front and the cools. It doesn't matter, you know, to the newer ones that are just learning or trying to have a go. That's probably even too technical too anyhow. It's probably too technical for me. Maybe a little bit of ultramarine in there, warmth, a little bit of that, eh? That might be a little bit overdone too. Let's see. No. Warm it up a bit. Warm it up, man. Give it a little bit of warmth, my friend. Oh, yeah. Oh yeah. I'm not even going to worry about that. I don't think I'll get too serious with that. I think that's okay, but I think I might have to do the same thing over here a little bit, because the eye runs out there where that softness is, where that soft colour is. It takes your eye out of the picture. So if I bring the darkness back in there, you see how it does it there? just having that little bit of the darkness there, that takes that away. It's strange, isn't it? You'd reckon the dark would make you take your eyes to it, but it's not. It's it is emotionally taking you to there where it is when it's soft. But then again, being soft goes on forever, doesn't it? Hard edges stop, if you know what I mean. Hard edges stop, soft ones keep going. Take you right through. If you can understand that lingo, my friends, I'd like it. You know, the emotional response to my brain is saying, hang on, that's looking, I'm feeling good with this. And I am the one that's got to feel good about the thing. And in general, if I feel good, there's going to be other people out there that are in the same emotional response and feel the same way. Now, there was orange in here. And it was nearly pure orange with the bushes. I don't know what the grasses or the bushes were, but they were orange, believe me. Had a little bit of orange in there too. But anyhow, I'm going to put a little bit of orange there too. And we don't have to make it into anything. You don't have to sculpture it into a bloody tree or anything. The idea is putting the colour that I felt when I seen that painting, right? When I was out there painting, I'm putting that colour back into it. And, you know, I could get real Luna Parky with the whole thing, but I ain't. You know, that to me is not too bad, just I'm going to leave it. I'm not going to get too fussed up with that stuff. I think this tree could still have a little bit of dark green in it. And so we'll just put the green in, but we'll have a little bit of darkness in the green with the green. Okay. Yeah, so there you go. All right, now this little bit in here could have a bit of that green, couldn't it? Just happening to be a little bit on the downside to that light, but there was probably a nice little bit of green heading across there. A warmer tight, put a little bit of CAD in there. See that? Seeing the CAD, the CAD's warmer. It's a bit warmer than the lemon. Yeah, lemon yellow's cool yellow. And this is, well, it's springtime, so it wasn't hot. I was in a shirt, it wasn't cold, I had a shirt on, a pair of shorts, so it was warmer. And I think that CAD yellow works a lot better with the whole feel of the painting. And just having these few little dark spots round in here, and I'll probably may put some twigs in there or something after, and maybe even have some twigs in there, right? I don't want to get too bright with them, you know what I mean? Yeah. Well, I can put them in with the branches in with a brush, little fine stick or something after. I make the medium a little bit sloppier, and that way the paint can just roll over the top of it. You can see here, you've got a bit of fence here that you've lost there. I'm just going to play around with a little bit of green, blue. I've got a little bit of lamp black in there, not that I use really, but I'm going to, because I think it might just suit the colour and the terrain. I don't use the black on its own, I have other colours mixed with it, because otherwise it gets real dirty. And I'm going to get a little thin brush, so that we do this right, my friend. And I probably won't be able to find one, because I probably haven't put them back. Well, they're up there, that's why. Not going to find them in with the other brushes, because they're not in there. They're in here. Okay, I'll say. So, we'll put a little bit of white, yellow, red, a little bit of everything in the thing, and I'm just going to No, we'll do this. Get that dark in there. A little bit of blue, a little bit of this. Now, I think that looks a little bit interesting. I reckon we need to even take a little bit of the fence in there too. State it, a little bit of fence there, okay? And I don't think it has to be perfect. It's just stating a fence, that's all I'm doing. And you probably won't even see it much, but at least it stands out that little tiny bit. And what we can do is even get this gate looking like a gate. I'm using a little bit of dry paint. You know what I mean, on the end of the brush? Everything seems to sit better when it's a little bit dry. When you're trying to do small little areas, it's a matter of getting to know how to use your mediums or your paint too. You know what I mean? Now, when I'm putting those little lines in here, they're actually going somewhere. Like, they feel like they're going somewhere. Then, what about that? I like it, that chimney, a bit of red, a bit of Yeah, very fair to lay. Okay, putting them in there. And I'm using a bit of old stuff and old paint here too, so. And yeah, it's good fun, you know, putting a little dab of colour here and there. It's an interesting part of doing the painting, building up those tiny little bits of lights and darks through the painting. When you look at the sky, I haven't copied the sky exactly naturally, but the light was changing and all the time, so I've just tried to recreate what I could feel in the painting. Well, you know, the blues are different, change, and the greys and the yellows and the oranges, and I could go through the painting for hours.
Yeah,
you know,
but man, as many hours go by with painting.
You know, I'm getting my day's pay, I suppose, for painting or something like that, but it's just a lovely way, you know, making a few bob and enjoying my life, you know, filling in my time with my life, you know. It's a lovely way to live.
Branches even in these things back here.
Okay, now
we can get a few little more twigs in there, only real thin though.
So what are we doing? We've already near gone 20 minutes, you know. I don't want to be playing around too much with the painting. I just thought I'd have a go at putting a few little changes in there. And what I really,
well, I put a few little twigs
over there. Huh? I want to state a little bit there. Try and mould in some colour around in here.
I'll put a bit of sirloin blue, a little bit, clean up some of the orange and the yellow there, mix it all together. Bit of cad yellow, cad red, cad yellow. And that's brought that up to
that colour. Okay. Now, that's not the colour I want, really.
So what I'm going to do is put some ultramarine in it and some cad yellow. See that?
And then that might be a little bit better. Uh-huh.
Cad yellow, ultramarine, and cad red. Righto, we're going to use that in the foreground. See if that no. There's a nice dirty colour
that we don't want,
so we'll put that a bit of sirloin blue in there, a lifesaver, you know, lemon.
You know, there's nothing that can't be gone over again, but I mean, yeah, it's nice to try and keep the colours clean. That's a bit dirty, but you know, I'll warm up a bit of red, a bit of cad red, and a bit of ultramarine blue or something. We'll fix that up.
Yep. Get a bit more of that in there. I'm sure this is
going to close out very shortly. That's all right.
Because that and that
going to fit in there somewhere, just to give that a little bit of life, that green. All right. Nice to have a little bit of textured paint. Not only feels right, it is right.
I'm going to grab a little bit more lemon yellow a little bit more lemon, lemon, yellow, mellow. Yes, I have been known to be a bit nutty, but I'm harmless. This is a little long. Trying to do the best I can.
Anyway, I'll show you the picture that started the whole thing, the whole journey of these paintings. These are the type of drawings that I do, a little 4x2. Just a simple pencil sketch, no sky in it. This is pinch of sky from nature, but just have a composition of a horizon and foreground with a little bit of a shade or some shape of whatever you're going to put into your painting. It's quite a simple way to do things, and it's quite enjoyable too. Yeah, so it's enjoyable. It's a beautiful way of painting, and you know, you get the emotional feeling from the sky to build up your painting. And you can, your brain will take you wherever it's got to take you to build up the painting, but it's nice to have that emotional. You take the sky away, there's no subject really, there's no feeling. The sky, the feeling's in the sky, and the sky is what sets the mood for the whole painting. As you're working down through the sky and you're building up those colours, it's an interesting way of doing the job. I love it.
Yeah, oh, I don't know. I'm just softening some of the edges. I don't want too many harsh edges, even in the foreground, you know what I mean? I don't know what's happening here, but, well, we're doing the best we can.
This is the first painting I've done out at Anil anyhow, so it's been about 3 hours, 2.5 to 3 hours up to this stage, and there is another footage of this, another 20 minutes of this footage in this thing, which I'll show you. And then I'll show you the four paintings that have been done out at Anil.
Okay. We need to have a bit of green out there. Can't just change dramatically from that to that, can it? So what we do is you just play a little bit of green in the foreground. And I think that green well, you know, man.